You deserve the glory and the honor. So I lift my hands in worship and I bless your holy name. You deserve the glory and all the honor. So I lift my hands in worship and I bless your holy name. For you are great, you do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. For you are great. You do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. Oh, and the honor. So I lift my hands in worship and I bless your holy name. You deserve the glory and all the honor. So I lift my hands in worship and I bless your holy name. For you are great, you do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. For you are great, you do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else. For you are great, you do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. You are great. You do miracles so great. Oh, there's nobody like you, Jesus. Nobody, nobody, nobody like you, Jesus. Oh, Lord, we can search high and low. We still won't find nobody like you. We just want to say thank you, Jesus, for being all that we need. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Nobody like you. Hallelujah. Lord God, we thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you for another chance. Hallelujah. Thank you for another chance, oh God, that you have given us on today. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for waking us up this morning, oh God. Thank you for starting us on our way. God, we want to open up our mouths. We're not going to hold back today. We're going to open up our mouths, Lord God, and say thank you. Thank you for all that you have supplied. Thank you for moving every mountain. Thank you for moving every valley. God, thank you for every good day. Thank you for every bad day. God, thank you. Hallelujah. We thank you that we're not laying in a hospital bed. God, we thank you. We thank you for being in our right minds. We thank you for the activity of our limbs. God, we thank you this morning. We give you all the praise, all the glory, all the honor, oh God, belongs to you. Father God, we stretch out our hands to you this morning, God, and we ask that you would just have your way. Hallelujah. Have your way in our lives. Have your way in our families. Have have your way, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We come this morning, God, for no other reason but to say thank you. We thank you, Lord God, for all that you have done up until this point in our lives. Lord God, you've been faithful. You've been committed. You've been awesome. Hallelujah. You've been a provider. You've been a strengthener. You've been a deliverer. You've been a healer. Oh God, you are the problem fixer. You are Alpha and Omega. You are the beginning and the end. And so, Lord, we ask, hallelujah, that you speak to us through your word on today. Lord God, we know that you have something to say. We know that you're always speaking. And so, Lord, whatever it is that you want to speak to us today, Lord God, we're open and we're willing to receive all that you have to say on today. Oh, yes. Hallelujah, God. We open up our hearts today. We open up our minds today. Lord God, give us understanding. Give us wisdom. Give us knowledge. Give us revelation through your word as to what you are requiring out of us in this season. Lord God, hallelujah. Let your blessings, let your favor, hallelujah, rain down on your people as they view, hallelujah, this broadcast. Hallelujah. I pray that the anointing will fall fresh on their lives. I pray, oh God, that they will draw nigh unto you. For your word says that when we draw nigh unto you, you will draw nigh unto us. And so, God, we ask, hallelujah, that you draw us closer to your anointing, closer to your word, closer to your son. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. God, we glorify you. We lift your name up. Hallelujah. We cast all our cares upon you, for your word says that you care for us. We're going to lay aside every weight. Hallelujah. That so easily besets us and keeps us from running this race. We're not going to allow stress. We're not going to allow worry, hallelujah, to tie us down today. We're going to give it all to you today. And we ask, oh God, that you do all of these things and more in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we do pray. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Good morning to you. Good morning. Hallelujah. Happy Sunday to everybody. Thank you for taking the time to tune in today. I am very grateful for all of you. God bless you. God bless you. I hope everyone is doing well. I hope that you are having a great weekend. You know, Sunday is always the beginning of the week, you know, so this is just a good time to make your goals, right? Make write out your dreams, write your vision down on tables, make it plain, right? Tell God whatever you want today. Tell him whatever it is that you desire, whatever it is that you need. Now is the time to tell him if it's a car, if it's a house, if it's money, if it's just for your health, if it's on behalf of somebody else that you know. Tell God whatever it is that you need. I just hear God say right now, now is the time to tell me what it is that you need and what you want. Come on, don't hold back. Open up your mouth and tell your Father what you need. He said, I'm more than able to do it. Glory to God. All you have to do is say in Jesus' name, Father God, I need you to do this for me. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Just tell him, hallelujah. He's right there with you. He is right there with you. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I feel his anointing. I feel his presence all around me. And I hope that you can feel him as well. So today I want to talk about the narrow and the broad road, or the narrow and the wide gates. That's what I want to talk about today. I remember as a child, I didn't quite understand what Jesus was talking about in this passage. I remember hearing this sermon. I remember hearing the scripture, and I just never really quite understood it. But as you get older, you start to understand scriptures that you heard as a child, or, you know, even if you're a baby in the faith, there are some things that you're going to read, and it's going to start to make sense to you as you grow in Christ. And so now that I've grown, I have a greater or better understanding of what Jesus was talking about in this chapter. I'm coming from Matthew 7, Matthew chapter 7, starting at verse 13, going to verse 14. So just two verses today, right? Two verses, but yet they're so powerful. Jesus says a whole lot in these verses, doesn't he? He makes a statement. And again, he's reminding us of what God is requiring out of us. God set the standard when he sent down his son, right? He set that standard for us when he sent Jesus. And Jesus died on that cross for our sins. even before he died, he's continued to set the standard, didn't he? I mean, he laid it out for us. He said, this is what I expect out of you. I'm showing you how to live. I'm showing you and I'm teaching you. Even with the disciples, he taught them. He showed them. He gave them parables, even though sometimes they didn't understand what he was talking about. He gave them something, hallelujah, to hold on to before he ascended into heaven. He says, here, I'm giving you my Holy Spirit that's going to also teach you and help you understand my word. He left us with an example, right? So we can't say that we don't know how to do these things. I don't know how, you may say, I don't know how to overcome. I don't know how to stop doing drugs. I don't know how to stop drinking alcohol. I don't know how to let go of the porn, of the pornography. I don't know how to let go of the sex. I don't know. I know I have a problem, but I don't know. What Jesus has given you, everything that you need, he's given you the keys. All you got to do is put the keys in the ignition and drive and go in God. God is giving you everything that you need, hallelujah, to help you to overcome. Overcome. And when I say overcome, I'm talking about this flesh. I'm talking about this flesh and all the things that we go through on a day-to-day basis. I'm talking about the struggles in life. I'm talking about setbacks. I'm talking about failures. I'm talking about disappointments. That's what I'm talking about today. When I say overcoming, overcoming the enemy, when the enemy tries to knock you down, tries to take everything that you work so hard for, when he tries to come in your family and destroy the love that is in your family, I'm talking about that. Jesus, hallelujah, has shown us how to overcome. And it's only by the power of the blood of Jesus that you are able to overcome those things. You don't have to be bound. You don't have to be bound by drug addiction. You don't have to be bound by alcoholism. You don't have to be bound by sex addiction. You don't have to be bound by pornography. You can be free today. Hallelujah. You don't have to be bound by gambling. Glory to God. God is able to heal you, able to deliver you. Glory to God. You don't have to be bound by depression and suicidal thoughts. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I was once bound by depression and suicidal thoughts. That was, 5 or 6 years ago? But God delivered me. But he didn't deliver me until I gave it to him. I laid it in his hands. And I never went back. I did not pick it up. I let him have it. Glory to God. I turned my life over to him completely. Glory to God. And maybe you're watching me and you say, well, I'm saved already. I've accepted Christ as my Lord and Savior. I accepted the Holy Spirit. I go to church faithfully, but there's this thing in my life that I'm struggling with. I'm here to tell you, when you let go and you let go of that control, you let go of what you thought you knew, and you just give it all to Jesus and let him take control, hallelujah, he is going to deliver you. He's going to help you to overcome. But first, we got to learn. We got to take our hands off of it. Glory to God. Let it go. Hallelujah. Acknowledge that you don't know what you're doing. Glory to God. That's number one. We got to acknowledge we don't know what we're doing as we walk down this thing called life. We don't know everything. And it's okay to not know everything. Glory to God. Hallelujah. It's good to say, Lord, I don't know everything. And I know that I need you to make it in this life. I need you every step of the way. So, Lord God, I don't know how to overcome. But I know that you know all things. And so I need you to help me to learn how to let go of this bad habit, because I can't do it by myself. I've tried and I didn't succeed. I failed once again. Lord God, I'm tired of failing. Hallelujah. I'm tired of being disappointed. I need you to come in my life and make a difference. I'm telling you, if you say that, hallelujah, and you mean it, God is going to come in your life. He's going to begin to show you things. Hallelujah. Glory to God in supernatural things. Hallelujah. He's going to show you ways of how to escape that temptation. I'm here to tell you, God is going to show you. Glory to God. But first, you got to let go. You got to let him take over. Hallelujah. So let's get started in this word. Hallelujah. Again, we're coming from Matthew 7 and 13 through 14. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. It says, enter ye in at the straight gate. For wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat. Because straight is the gate, and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there will find it. Okay, so let's break the scriptures down. So why is the road to Christ so narrow? Just ask yourself that. Why is the road to Christ so narrow? What is it about seeking after the things that are godly that makes the road so narrow, you know, really, really narrow? What is it? What is it about that road that people, or that gate, that people don't want to go through that gate? They don't want to go down that road. What is it that keeps people from being free? What is it that's keeping you from being free? What is it that's keeping you, making you want to continue to stay bound? Hallelujah. What is it? What is it? Think about that. Why is the road to Christ so narrow? And why do people reject Christ so much when they know that he's done things for them? They know that he sacrificed, he's had mercy on them. He knows that, they know that he's saved them. He's been there for them, provided for them. Why? Why do we continue to reject the things of Christ? So we're getting ready to find out. Number one, Jesus says in verse 14, he says that the narrow gate leads to life. Okay, I'm going to say it again. In verse 14, Jesus said the narrow gate is basically life. So when I go down the path of Christ, I obtain life. So what is life? Jesus is talking about eternal life. He's talking about having a life and life more abundantly. Even as you live on this earth, when you begin to live in Christ and you begin to seek after the things of God, you are going to begin to see your life turn around. Things in your life are going to begin to change. Your attitude changes. Your personality changes. Why does it change? Because now you are patterning yourself after Christ. We know that Christ is perfect. We know that there's no sin in Christ. We know that there's no guilt in Christ. We know that anything that pertains to God or his darling son or anything that's heavenly, we know that it's holy. We know that it's beautiful. We know that it's perfect. So as you go down this road that's going towards Jesus, your life is going to become more like his life, right? Your life is going to have order and structure. And some of you are dealing with a chaotic life. You cannot seem to figure out why your life continues to have drama and chaos. What I'm here to tell you, there's something in your life, hallelujah, that is not lining up with the will of God. God is trying to tell you. I don't know who this is for. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody, I don't know, that's going to watch me. God is trying to tell you, and I feel the anointing of God. Hallelujah. That is not my will for your life. You wonder why you keep having all of these things going wrong. God is trying to tell you, that's not the life that I had planned for you. Glory to God. I'm trying to tell you, says the Spirit of God, that the way that you are going is not my will and my destiny for your life. He says, turn around. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So when we start to go down this life, but we go down this life with Jesus, our lives begin to change. And we see a difference in the way that we live. And our attitude and our personality, our characteristics start to line up with that of God. Hallelujah. And he says that the narrow gate is life. So when we start to walk with God, we start to see, like I said before, a change. We start to actually live life. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We start to understand how life is short. We start to understand why this road is narrow. Because, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. See, down this road, there's things that you have to give up. But there's things that you give up really weren't good for you in the beginning. Oh my goodness. Hallelujah. I'm going to say that again. When we walk in through this thing called life with God, there's things that you're going to have to give up. And we know, come on, we know, let's be honest. We know that some of these things that we need to give up, we know that goes for me, that goes for you. We know that these things are not good for us. We know that these things are toxic. We know they're dysfunctional, but we hold on to them because they're like a temporary fix. And I'm going to get to that later. But these things we have to give up because we know that they're not good for us. Not only that, but God knows what's best for you. You don't know, hallelujah, what's really best. We don't really know, right? Sometimes we don't know. But God knows. Why? Because he created you and he knows everything about you. He knows all about those internal things. He knows things that people don't know or that people can't see. So that's why he knows what's best for us, because he's the one that made us and formed us, glory to God, in our mother's womb. So scripture says in 1 John 5:12, we're going to talk about life. Just give you some scriptural, you know, examples of what Jesus is talking about when he says life. So 1 John 5:12 says, whoever has the Son has life. Whoever does not have the Son of God does not have life. Just as plain as day. That's what it says. If you have Jesus, you got life. But if you don't have him, you don't have life. You got chaos. You got confusion. You got sadness. You even got depression. Glory to God. But with God, I know that I have life. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. So let's go read some other scriptures. Let's go to John 14:6. Let's go to John 14:6. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. John 14:6. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. John 14:6. Hallelujah. Says, Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes unto the Father but by me. So what did he say again? He says, I'm the way, I'm the truth, and I'm the life. That means that he is the only way. That means that I cannot sit here and try to convince myself that I can make it without him. I can't make it without Jesus. Why? Because he's already said, and Jesus said this himself. He says, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. That means I need him. Every step of the way, I need Jesus in my life. I cannot make it. I can't make it through this life without knowing him. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Let's go to John 10:10. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. John 10:10. Glory to God. It says, the thief cometh not, but to steal and to kill and to destroy. He says, but I've come that they might have life and that they might have it more abundantly. And I'm just going to read the next verse. It says, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. So he says, the enemy, Satan, has come to steal every good thing in your life. He's come to destroy you. He's come to put those negative thoughts in your mind. He's come to attack you in your mind and tell you everything that God did not say. Are you hearing me today? That's what his purpose is. So Jesus said, in order for you to overcome and to beat him, you got to have me in your life. He says, I am come that they might have life and that they might have it more abundantly. So what is God saying? Glory to God. What is he saying? He says that when you follow down the path of destruction, you're not going to have life. You're not going to have life. Glory to God. Romans 6:23 says, the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. So when you choose sin, you are basically choosing death. When you choose to live a life of sin and bondage, you are basically saying, I'm choosing death. But Jesus has already said that the gift of God is eternal life. If I want to live, if I want to be prosperous, I got to start taming this flesh. I got to start being disciplined. I got to start doing it God's way if I want to live. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So let's go to Philippians 1. Philippians 1 and 21. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I hope this is making sense to somebody on today. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So Philippians 1 and 21. And it says, "For to me to live is Christ, and to die is gain." Glory to God. So what does that mean? It says, for to me, living is for Christ, and dying is even better. Why? Why does he say this? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Why does he say this? Glory to God. Because he understood. Hallelujah. He says living for Christ and dying is even better, because he understood that even living on the earth, even living in the present, glory to God, if I choose Christ, I have life. But even if I die, I still got life, because then I'm going to have eternal life. Are you hearing me today? So either way, I have life. Either way, I'm good. Either way, God is going to bless my life, because I choose him in the living and after death. Glory be to God. Either way, I'm still good, because I'm living for God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Let's move on. Hallelujah. So let's go on to talk about how Jesus says he's the true vine. And this is just another example. Let me go back. I should have stayed in John. Glory to God. John 15 and 4. John 15 and 4. This is one of my favorite chapters. I love this chapter. John. Let's go to John. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. John chapter 15. John chapter 15, verse 4. It says, "Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine, no more can ye, except you abide in me." I'm going to read it again. He says, "Abide in me." This is Jesus talking. "And I in you. As the branch can't bear fruit on its own, but it must abide in the vine. No more can you, except you abide in me." So we know that a fruit tree, right? A vine can't bear any fruit unless it's still attached to the vine, right? The vine is the one that gives it life. The vine is the one that allows it to be able to bear fruit. So Jesus is saying, he says in the same way, you can't live, hallelujah, without me. I am the one who gives you life. I'm the one who can take it away. I'm the one who gives you the opportunity to be great, to be successful. He says, I'm the one who helps you to bear the fruit that's in your life. You have not just got where you are by yourself. It was God that was with you. Hallelujah. Think about that. It's been him that has been blessing you. It's been him that's been prospering you. It was him that protected you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Nobody but Jesus. So he said, you got to abide in me and I in you. So when I abide in my Father, glory to God, he says, I'm going to be with you. As you seek me, I'm going to be with you. Draw nigh unto me and I'll draw nigh unto you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I've got to seek after Jesus. I got to study his word. I got to keep going to church. Glory to God. I got to keep reading my word. I got to keep spending time with him. Because see, when I do that, I'm abiding in him. Oh my goodness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Somebody watching me right now, it's been a long time since you got down on your knees and prayed. Somebody watching me right now, it's been a long time since you've been in church. And I understand that I understand the COVID-19. I understand that. That's understandable. But even before, a lot of people had left the faith. A lot of people had left God. A lot of people, glory to God, had turned their back on Jesus. What is he saying today? Glory be to God. What is the Holy Spirit speaking to you today? And I know that he is. What is he saying? He's saying that it's time to come back. Glory to God. He says, abide in me and I in you. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. So let's move on. In verse 13, Jesus refers to the gate to hell as being broad and wide. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So Jesus says, going to hell is easy. I'm going to say that again. Going to hell is easy. Glory to God. Let me read New Living Translation to you. Glory to God. So that you can have a better understanding. It says, you can enter God's kingdom only through the narrow gate. The highway to hell is broad and it's narrow. It's broad and its gate is wide for the many who choose the easy way. Glory be to God. So that lets us know that the broad and the wide gate is easy to go through. It's easy to find yourself in hell. Glory to God. If you go down this gate. So let's go to Proverbs. Let's go to Proverbs. Glory to God. Let's go to Proverbs. Proverbs 15. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Proverbs 15. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Proverbs 15 and 24. Hallelujah. It says, the way of life is above to the wise, that he may depart from hell beneath. The path of the wise leads to life above. They leave the path of the grave. They leave the grave behind. So again, Christ is life, but to follow after sin is death. Hallelujah. Let's go to Matthew 25. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Matthew 25. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Matthew 25 and verse 46. Verse 46. It says, and these shall go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous into life eternal. And they will go away into eternal punishment, but the righteous will go into eternal life. And so, again, Jesus lays it out for you. He says, if you want to live, if you want to live in the present, in the living, and after death, you got to choose me. Hallelujah. Jesus is saying, there's a certain standard that I have for you to live. Glory to God. And it's up to you. God says, I'm not going to push my standards nor my commandments on you. I've laid it out there for you. I've sent people. I've sent prophets. I've sent evangelists. I've sent my people out to you. I sent my only darling son to give you an example and to show you what it is that I expect out of you if you choose to follow me. But if you say you believe in me, if you say you love me, then it shouldn't be hard for you to choose me. Yes, sometimes we don't choose God. Sometimes we choose to do our own thing. Sometimes we choose to go down our own path. But even then, God's hand of mercy is still there. And God is still saying, even today, turn back to me. Turn your hearts back to me. Because when you choose me, you are choosing life. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So he says that this broad and this wide gate is easy. Anybody can go down this way, right? It's easy to go down, right? Glory to God. So let's move on. Number three, the gate to life is small and narrow. And he said that few will ever find it. I'll say that again. The gateway to life. Who is life? God. Hallelujah. Is small and narrow. And few will ever find it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So let's move on. Why does he say that? What is the difference between a narrow and a wide gate? So let's talk about that. Let's talk a little bit about that. Now, we're just going to, you know, kind of talk about, in your mind, I just need you to kind of picture a narrow gate and a wide gate, right? Now, let's think about this. When you go down a narrow gate, and I know you probably, you know, especially when you go to like amusement park. So when you go to like a fair, you know, sometimes they may have a gate that is really small, right? And you try to go through because you're so excited. You want to get there so fast. You want to go ride through all the different little rides. And, you know, you want to maybe get cotton candy or funnel cake. And so, you know, especially when you're as a kid, you know, you try to go through with another kid, right? You try to go through the gate together. But, you know, you both can't go through that gate because it's so narrow. But you're so excited, you don't care. You know, you're trying to squeeze through that gate, but you know in your mind that gate is too narrow. You can't. two people are not able to go through the gate, right? Okay, so now you got that vision in your head. Now visualize a wide gate, right? Everybody is able to go through that gate, right? It's easy. Maybe like 4 or 5 people, or maybe 6. Depending on how wide it is, they can pretty much get through that gate and can walk in a line and still make it, right? Without even brushing their shoulder up against the sides of the gate. So I want you to envision that in your mind, okay? Now that you got that vision, I'm explaining this. So why is this gate so narrow, right? When I think about a narrow gate, again, it's hard to get through. Everybody can't go through it, right? Again, because you basically got to squeeze, right? You got to, you know, it's narrow. And most people don't want to go through a narrow gate. Why? Because it's uncomfortable. Keyword, uncomfortable. A narrow gate is uncomfortable, right? Okay, so when we're talking about a broad, when Jesus says a broad and a wide gate, it's comfortable, right? Because you don't have to do none of this. You ain't got to suck in your stomach, right? You don't have to do any of those things. You just walk through the gate. It's easy, right? You don't have to think about it. You don't have to think about how you're going to walk through that wide gate. You just simply walk through it, right? My God, hallelujah. Shekeya, baboko shokorobo, shekeya, hallelujah. That gate is broad. It's easy. It's comfortable. And so what is Jesus saying? That the narrow gate, it requires you to have discipline. My goodness. The narrow gate requires you to sacrifice some things. The narrow gate, hallelujah, glory to God, requires you, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, to tighten up your loins, hallelujah. The narrow gate requires you to let go of some things, hallelujah. Glory to God. But the broad gate is comfortable. It doesn't really require any discipline. You don't have to think about it. You just go. No constraints. No discipline. No nothing. Just going about your way. No thought. Nothing. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So which gate are you going through today? Think about it. I want you to think about it. Which gate are you going through? You know, people love the wide gate because they don't have to give up anything. They can live how they want to without any pressure, without thinking about what they're doing. No conscience, no guilt, no shame. They just go through that gate, right? Because it's easy. Well, everybody else is doing it, so I can do it. Well, everybody else is using drugs. I can do it too. But what is Jesus saying? That down this narrow gate, yes, yes, you're going to have to be more disciplined. Yes, you're going to have to give up some things. Yes, you're going to have to sacrifice some things. But we've already established that those things are not good for us anyway. We don't need them anyway. They haven't brought us good luck anyway. Hallelujah. Yes, you're going to have suck in that stomach to get through that narrow gate. But guess what? That narrow gate leads to life. When I say life, I'm talking about life after death. Down this narrow gate, I'm going to see Jesus. I'm not going to go to hell and burn for eternity. Oh, no. I'm going with Jesus. I'm going to go to a place where I no longer have to worry anymore. I'm going to go to a place where I'm going to be laughing and smiling. Are you hearing me today? I'm going to a place where I'm going to have a mansion. I'm going to walk down the streets of gold. I'm going to get to see those pearly gates that the word talks about. Hallelujah. I'm going to see Jesus. I'm no longer going to be in pain. No longer going to be sick. No more diabetes. No arthritis. No high blood pressure. No more cancer. Hallelujah. I hope somebody is understanding today. I hope that you are really understanding. Glory to God. But that wide gate leads to hell, damnation, the gnashing of teeth. Glory to God. So what is your choice today? Which one seems a little bit more easier to do? Which one seems a little bit more attractive? Glory to God. You have a choice. Thank you, Jesus. You have a choice. God is giving you free will. He says, I'm not going to push myself on you. I have laid it out for you. I've told you what I am expecting. Glory to God. If you want to live, you got to choose Jesus today. Hallelujah. I'm going to say that again. If you want to live, you got to choose Jesus. That is the only way that you're going to have eternal life. No, there's not no shortcut. And that's another thing with this narrow road. You notice it's narrow for a reason, because there are no shortcuts. Oh, bless your name, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. There are no shortcuts. There is no other pathway. There is no other way. The word has already told us. Jesus said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Hallelujah. Sorry about that. That's our house alarm or whatever, our security. But he says, there's no other way. I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No one gets to the Father except by me. He is the only way. He is the only way. Glory to God. He is the only way. I said, he is the only way. Choose life. Choose God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So which gate are you going to go through? Which gate are you going to go through? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Which gate are you going to go through today? Hallelujah. Which gate? Which gate are you going through today? What gate have you been walking through today? What are you doing? How are you living? Hallelujah. Some of you, God has kept you. God has provided for you. Some of you have been in car accidents. Some of you have been sick. Some of you were almost to the point of death. But God saved you. He gave you another chance. What are you doing with your life? Hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm not here to make you feel good. Hallelujah. I'm not here to tell you, oh, well, you can live however you want and God's still going to bless you. God loves everybody, but he has also set a standard. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I'm here to tell you the truth because somebody told me the truth. I would have never turned my life around if somebody had not have told me that God has called you to a life of holiness. I would not be living the life that I live if I had not have chose God. So, last verse, glory to God, John 8 and 32 says, and you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. I'm going to read that again. And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. That's what the word says. After you've heard the truth, it makes you free. And people struggle to hear this truth. And the truth of the matter is, there is a hell and there is a heaven. And at some point, you got to make up in your mind. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You got to make up in your mind. Am I going to choose life? Or am I going to choose death? And you say, well, I'm young. I got plenty of time. That is a lie from the pits of hell. Don't let the devil lie to you. Glory to God. Don't let Satan lie to you. Yes, you are young. But you got to understand, life is short. Glory to God. We've got young people that are leaving here every single day. I'm talking about 15-year-olds, 16-year-olds, 20-year-olds, even people my age and older. So it doesn't matter how old you are. Glory to God. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter how old you are. And that is the lie that the enemy is telling a lot of young people, is that you're young. Don't worry about trying to go to church. Don't worry about that. You just live your life. Have fun. You know, it's okay to have fun. But you got to be disciplined. There are some things that you know are not godly in your life. You know that God is not pleased with. And every time you do it, he turns his face against you. You already know these things. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Accept what God is saying to you today. Stop running. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So I pray that this word was easy to understand today. God wants you to have life. It is not in his will for you to go to hell. Glory to God. He wants you to go to heaven. He wants you to have eternal life. That's why he sent his son down here, so you could have a chance. That's why he died, so that you can have a chance at having eternal life. This is not just for the Jews. This is for the Greeks and the Gentiles. That means that this gospel is for all of us. No matter where you come from, no matter what your race, no matter where your what your culture is, it's for everybody. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So if you do not know Christ, glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. If you do not know Jesus today, I want to extend, hallelujah, Christ to you today. God loves you. Hallelujah. He desires to be in your life. He desires to get to know you. He desires for you to get to know him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. He desires to do things in your life. He desires that relationship. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Open up your heart today. Thank you, Jesus. Open up your heart today and allow him to come in. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Allow him to come in. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. So if you don't know God, you never accepted Christ as your Lord and Savior, I invite you to open up your heart and receive him unto yourself. Glory to God. Hallelujah. This is not about me. This is not about anybody else. This is all about you and your soul. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You can't stand with your husband and your wife. Glory to God, when you stand before God, you will not be able to stand with anybody else but yourself. So if you don't know Christ today, Romans 10:9 says, confess with your mouth and believe in your heart, hallelujah, that Jesus, hallelujah, is the Son of God, and God raised him from the dead. It says that you shall be saved. If you say, Lord, I want you to make me over today, I believe that you are the Son of God. I believe that you are real, that you sit on the right hand of God the Father. I want you to become a part of my life. I want you to come into my life. I want you to come into my heart. My friends, you are now, hallelujah, you're now saved. And you now belong to the body of Christ. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Somebody out there singing, come on. God wants to do great things in your life. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. As this song plays, I pray that it would minister to you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Time I failed you. Here I am.
pierced your side when they already nailed you. Jesus, heal my open wound. I just want to be more like you. Father, I let you down. Was not like you, just take it out. Reconcile me, Jesus. I just wanna be. Wash me and make me whole.
Everybody sing it, Lord, make me over.
Lord, make me over. Lord, make me over. Lord, make me over. Make me over again. Make me over.
Come on, tell him, Lord, make me over today. Lord, make me over. Hallelujah. I want to start fresh. I want to be new again. Hallelujah. Hear me again, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So, Lord, make me over. Hallelujah. Lord, I know you. I'm saved, but I've been doing some things that I know is not pleasing to you. Lord, make me over again. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Turn my life around. Hallelujah. Come on, open up your heart. Open up your heart. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Give it all to Him. Come on, give it to Him. Give it to Him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Oh, Lord, make me over. Lord, make me over today.
If you want to change all over the building, let me hear you say, oh.
Make me over
today. Let me hear you say, oh.
Again, God bless you. Thank you so much for watching today. I pray, hallelujah, that you feel refreshed in your spirit. Choose God. Choose Christ. And you will have eternal life. You will experience the abundant life. Choose God today. Hallelujah. You don't have to be bound. You don't have to be in that place that you've been in for years, for months. God wants to make you over. He wants to change your life. Turn it totally around. Glory to God. I'm talking about a 360 turnaround. Hallelujah. He can do it. If He did it for me, He can do it for you. Glory to God. Again, thank you for tuning in today. Glory to God. I pray, hallelujah, that this word will stay with you even through the week. I pray that the Spirit of God will continue to speak to you. Glory to God. And I know that He's speaking to you even right now. Hold on to Christ. Hold on to your faith. Hold on to the Word of God, and it will never lead you astray. Which road and which gate are you going down? Will it be the narrow or will it be the broad? Glory to God. God bless you, and may the Lord continue to keep you.